Welcome to week 7 of the Joe Reich Show here in the 2011 Wingate football season as we look back on the week that was in Bulldog football and preview the week ahead. I'm your host, Ryan Brown, alongside Wingate football coach Joe Reich. Well, week 7 found the Bulldogs playing back at Irwin Belk Stadium for the final regular season conference game at home. The Wingate Bulldogs welcome in the Newberry Wolves, a great rivalry through the past few years between these two teams, and another close game for Wingate football. The Bulldogs stop a late two-point conversion and win 31-29 to move to 3-1 in South Atlantic Conference play. Coach Reich, who felt like that game against Newberry was kind of like a couple of the ones last year. It wasn't a spectacular game, but it was a good, solid team win, and, you know, happy to have it out of the way with you guys on the right side.
Yeah, I agree with that. We said that after the game, that we really just felt like it was a good team win. There was a lot of positive things from all different areas. Good, solid team win. Definitely felt good to come out on the winning side of that.
You know, in the first couple of weeks of the season, kind of struggling that first half, came alive in the second half. Now you've kind of been solid in this first half in the last two games, and kind of struggled in the second half.
Right.
You know, is that just kind of the nature of the games? Because it doesn't feel like a big concern. You guys needed the touchdown in the fourth quarter to get the lead up to 8, and you did. And you know, a week too late against Mars Hill, but finally got back to what you needed in the second half.
Yeah, it's funny because I've had a lot of people ask me that. I think some of that is just the ebb and flow of the game. I felt like we managed the game pretty well in the second half against Newberry. I didn't feel like we were struggling in the second half. You know, we certainly didn't have the scoring output that we had in the first half. But you know, I felt like the game was in hand. We were managing the game well. The late pick at the end of the game was a little bit of a fluke in that, you know, we'd run the ball first and second down trying to milk the clock a little bit. We threw a fairly conservative pass that he's got a little lucky to, you know, tip the ball. Well, not lucky. The guy made a nice play, tipped the ball up in the air, and they got the pick and drove it in from there. So, it was a different feel than the Mars Hill game. But the Mars Hill game, I think Mars Hill just really caught fire, and we struggled a little bit. And whereas this game, you know, it felt like it was in control even up until the end.
Wingate and Newberry, highlights from Saturday's South Atlantic Conference matchup. A beautiful day again for football, and just a little bit of cool in the air, but, you know, went from the all-Navy coach back to the gold pants.
Right.
You know, get to debut one more time.
That's right.
What'd you think about Newberry's opening possession? A couple passes and a run, second down when they went the run, and then the interception on third down.
Yeah, you know, I think they're still trying to find their stride a little bit offensively, and you know, we were hoping they weren't going to find it in this game. I think they've got some individually, they've got some talent. They're just trying to find the right mix, I think, of who's doing what.
So Risper with the interception, he ducks right under, and we'll watch it again here as he comes in. Looks like he's scoring. I'm on the broadcast saying, you know, touchdown. You know, second straight home game, we get a touchdown defensively. Watch it again. The referees call Risper out of the 10, and I don't see it. I'm trying to figure out where he steps out because Max Melton, the head of referee, didn't call it. If you look at it once again, I don't see it, but they say he steps out at the 10, and you kind of offensively stall a little bit there and come up empty. Grammaticopoulos will watch this play to get you guys down to 10, but again, just a little bit of a stall. You know, thought you had 6. There's the third down play, knocked down, and then Paul trying to get his first attempt, just kind of got a big chunk of Halfley's hand. Watch the replay again, but talk about this. You know, to your credit, you let him go back out there.
You know, Paul's really fast to the ball. And, you know, that's one of the things we like him. And he just, you know, he was so fast that time that Hunter just never had a chance to move his right hand out of the way.
Newberry's next drive after the missed field goal. We saw this a lot. Looked kind of like Valdosta's offense, kind of that keeper with the quarterback option there.
Yep.
And then they fumbled, just a mishandled connection there between the quarterback and running back. You guys get it right back and a good start here, and felt like you had more room and felt more comfortable.
Yeah, it's funny because I think Newberry did a great job in the red zone the first series down. They made a couple adjustments coming in that's one of the reasons why the first series stalled. We get down here, felt like we were going to punch it in, you know, had to settle for the field goal here. But again, just trying to get Paul back out there and get him his first field goal, and obviously he did a great job. Great hold by Hunter, and back on the board.
So Wingate leads 3-0 this late in the first quarter. Get the ball back again, and a great catch and a lot of yards after the catch. We talk about that a lot. Bowden takes a shot, hangs on, and then he'll score next a couple plays later. Great little route here between him and Clawson. We'll watch that here in a second. That was the play to Caffrey. Here's the play. Just nice little duck inside.
Yeah, and again, Chris did a real nice job just tucking underneath. Josh did a great job of just hitting it over the top, drawing the defense out, and Chris just gets over the end line. Cody, great job of getting there quickly.
So another good start by your team. And again, Newberry just struggling to get anything going against this defense. It's really starting to come alive in this first half.
Yeah, and I think our defense is playing real well early. I think they're really gelling and coming together well.
Here's a third down play. Again, Kazazian all over it on the near side. Did well not to get a flag there.
Yeah, and that's something we've talked about. We ended up getting one in the game, but that was more on special teams. Josh coming here, great job bursting through, great job with the offensive line.
Coach, a little trickeration here, and
boy, I thought
Cody,
we had this.
just a bit too much.
Just a little over the top.
Yeah, great effort there by Marquise. You end up having a punt. Newberry comes back down. Trying to find Bostic in the corner. It's hard to miss a guy like that. And then a great play here by Fletcher, knocking it down. Feel like you're going to get it stopped, but then they score here on third down.
Yeah, and again, just good throw here in the end zone camera. The kid made a great throw just over the head of our middle linebacker. Nice throw. When that kid is on, he's really good.
So a quarter and a half, we only get 10-7 score, but this is when it just starts to open up. Lantigua, a great return. Gets you guys good field position. And again, it felt like Caffrey's taking over Ellington's role of just, he always takes a huge hit every game.
He really does. But he gets yards. He gets tough yards after the catch. Just doing a great job for
Clawson us. Clawson quietly just having a solid season. And then Nellenweg twice into the end zone again. And, you know, you can feel like you can get these yards with him in this distance.
Yeah, and again, the more we can get out of a run game, the better off we're going to be. And I think that's been since Vince got hurt, Andrew's really picking up the slack. There's two freshman kids that we're putting in there as well. Doing a great job, and they're not freshmen anymore. They've been through the ringer now, so the more we can get out of those three guys and out of our run game, the better.
Nice tackle there by Grammaticopoulos, but a good return for Newberry. Again, what a shot by Simmons on the quarterback, but pass interference is called. So Newberry's driving down, and just kind of a little fade up here, Bostic. I mean, if I'm a coach of Newberry, I'm just running that play every time. He's 6'5", 240. I'm running that play every time.
He is a physical specimen. I tell you, he was standing in front of us on the sideline. He was in front of us in a formation. I was like, good, muggly wuggly, yeah. Look at this guy. I mean, really, and it's funny because our players all said the same thing. Very nice young man. After the game, a competitor, but a guy who just, our guys had some good conversations with during the game.
So Newberry scores, but right back you come. And what a play here by Ellington. Brandon getting just held the whole way down, still holds on and makes the score. He's becoming a guy that's going to have one or two catches a game, but you know what, one of them is going to be a score. But again, Coach, you're just unable to get the stop here to go into the half. Newberry, to their credit, comes down. Ehrlich scrambles, and then he takes a shot here. His knee kind of gets caught under, and Merton comes in and scrambles. And, just one of those things, couldn't get that stop at the end.
No, this was a key play. The kid did a nice job of pulling the ball down and getting the first down.
And there's the play that, to say the least, got you a little bit upset. You can see both wide receivers at the top of the screen. We froze it for you there to see. They were both already gone. And then here's the play with 2 seconds left, diving over the top. And Newberry would get on the board there before the half. But a huge play in the game. Their kicker misses his first extra point of the season.
Right.
And through all of that, you're not thinking, well, we gained a little momentum back from that because we didn't, Wingate didn't like the way the half ended.
Right.
But once you got to go to the locker room and just let it go and come back out, all right, now we're up four. We get a big special teams play there. They missed the extra point.
Right.
And we're feeling better, once you came back out of the locker room.
It's amazing what one little extra point can do in terms of when you don't get an extra point or the other team doesn't get the extra point. When it's the other team and they don't get it, there's definitely a little bit, all right. It's like you cheated death there to a certain extent. So, at halftime, our guys felt good. Like you could kind of look in their eyes. I think they were very confident. They're very comfortable that they were going to have some success in the second half. So, I thought they did a nice job. Our guys did a good job just kind of regrouping, saying, let's come back out in the second half and get this thing done.
Once again, turnovers were a big part of that the first half. Get a couple fumbles from them.
Right.
And again, it didn't really feel like the second half was mostly going to be generated the outcome of the score by that. It felt like, I thought, for the first time in a lot of games, that we didn't feel like it was going to be a turnover battle in the second half, but it was going to be, who can hold the ball more.
Right.
And you guys ended up doing that in the second half.
Yeah, really, it was I think, again, to the defense's credit, to be able to come out and do some good things there in the second half, and offensively, we really controlled the clock, controlled the game a little bit. Like I said, I felt like we managed the second half well. I would have liked to have seen a few more points, but, it just had a good feel to it the whole way. Like we felt like we were in control most of that second half, for sure.
Well, Wingate